Hello, everybody! Welcome to the next episode of Epic Fumble! And I surprised my players because I didn't make the transition usually.
That's fine.
So, yes, a little new overlay because since I rebooted everything, I had to redo everything. So, just change the pace. More of our faces instead of just like really small squares and all that. So, and
oh no, the horror.
Yes. But, you know, it's been a while since we played this game. It's been a month now. And who in the whole group of you would be ready for a recap and having a D4? And I haven't set up the D4s for that. So you'll have to remember.
I got some stuff right now.
So do I, which is a rarity for me.
Well, did you want to take it away?
You know what? I'm going to give it a shot. It's going to be terrible, but I'm going to give it a shot. So the last session, as far as my notes and my absolutely terrible memory goes, we had a fight to start with. It was pretty rough. Both Abelus spawns and sea serpents. I was a snack for a while. I don't recommend it. Stomach acid.
You're always a snack, Bert.
Yeah, but I'd rather not be that kind of snack. Because I know I'm a snack. But now I was an actual snack, like chomped. Mm-hmm. It was unpleasant. So after we wrapped that whole business up, we ended up at this nearby tower where we found this spirit of an orc. Which was very confusing to, I mean, at least me. An orc that was actually alive during the calamity. Hence when we walked in is basically thinking it was still back then and they were still being attacked by gods. We managed to convince him that that was a long, long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. So he kind of calmed down.
That's on the Thursday games every 2 weeks now.
True, it's not that long, long time ago. And in a channel that is this channel. Tune in on Thursdays for Star Wars.
Yeah.
Shameless plug. So this orc spirit happened to be a true believer of Corellon. So he was able to get us into the temple, which was nice to finally manage. And looking at the map, that is where our character icons are still. So I managed to... avoid massive trouble when I went and touched a giant crystal in the center because, I mean, it's bricks. Big shiny, he's got to touch it.
Abu!
Correct, just like, touch the thing. And at which point, I had a vision of good old Elixion, this person we've been chasing for... We're game 31, right?
Yes, sir.
For basically 30 games now. Who was begging for someone to free him because he can't do it himself. Beyond that, I left myself a note of something to remember, which is good because I've obviously forgotten that. And I have a note that I got a brooch because Squish gave me a brooch. It was nice.
Brooch of shielding.
Yeah, which I don't think is actually in my inventory, but I'll go find it.
DDB. It should be in the DDB items, so... Yes, yeah. You can drag it up to your inventory.
And then Timber has the Ring of Shooting Stars. Mother Bullet has Sentinel Shield. Mm-hmm. And I believe I was given the Long Sword, because that's the one with the...
Rudium. And the ghost offered to go fetch the great axe, the Rudium great axe for Andy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we need to give our himbo a bigger, nastier weapon.
I mean,
the mold's working fine.
I can't use my crusher feet with a great axe, so I'll probably stick to my maul anyway.
But you just put it on your back. And then you look even more, or like, big and strong. Because you have two weapons. And then everyone wonders if you use two-handed weapons.
I mean, I do have an extra pair of hands with my echo.
That's true. That's true, but it's mimicking the one you have in hand.
I know. It was a
joke. But yes, anything to add up for this little recap? Or is it going to be it for tonight?
That's pretty much what happened.
That's what I got. I surprisingly think that actually covers everything.
For once, we went the route of diplomacy.
True.
I mean,
talking with the ghost instead of smacking it.
I remember
punch a ghost.
One thing. I received a blessing from their god. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, from Corel and the Archheart. You were taking a long rest inside there while the ghost would be guarding. But anyway, you're still into the force field of this place because you were invited by a believer in Corellin.
Woo!
So anything outside cannot even think going in. And for once, you're inside a dry place. There's no water inside there. So it's a bit warm to the heart that you're not into freezing water for once.
We're actually not moist.
Ooh, 7.8 on 10, too much water.
And let me just add back this image to copy and then paste for our friend Timber that received a D4 from... Or Dark Knight, second Sugar Mama, that's not there on Thursdays, but it's okay. I still love you.
Of course we do. You're still my DM, too.
Yes, yes. I always give the love. Yeah. All the love. And the D4 to me, the DM, and I'm setting up the little D4s. Well, I can just a bit. So with that long rest, there is no vision that comes to you. There's no torment. Because last time you were around this place, there was this aboleth tricking with your mind. But you beat the shit out of it, and all the freaking serpent in the region. But you also been warned that inside the Netherdeep, it's probably from where these creatures come from. So it's still not reassuring. But since you're in safety, anybody wants to do a little something before the morning comes?
Well, how about we roll our HP because we're level 10 now?
Yes, 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 yes.
Good thing to start with before I get onto the other thing.
Yes, indeed. So I'll invite Timber to roll first. Did you multi-class?
I'm a rogue. No. What's druid again? D8? No.
Yes, D8.
Okay. I click on the wrong thing. 1d8. This is average, right? I've never beaten average so far. It's been a year, I think. Yeah.
Yes, you're usually in the average most of the time.
Never went above average. Never touched my HP.
It's okay. I'm a benevolent god, so you still have always the average. And it will also be the same thing with the next campaign of Exandria.
Woo!
So, talking about that, Harry, it's your turn. D10. And thank you for the lurk, Point PS Dolls. See you later.
I'll take average for sure.
Yes, so 6 HP plus constitution for Andy. And Mother Bowen, who forgot to actually take the plus 2 or feat at level 8, can now roll her HP. A D8, please, milady.
Yes, sir.
8, Mother Bowen Tenki Momo.
Yay! I'm a chunky mommy.
All right. And let's follow up with a Xing Xing Squish Quash.
Yeah.
And don't forget your plus 1 HP from Draconic Bloodline. 1. Oh no. Sorcerer have D6? It's not only wizards that have that?
No, I got a D6.
So 4. Plus kind, plus stuff.
Yep. So, yeah.
And let's go up with Brix. And Brix, by the way, I didn't give you a D4. I gave a floating inspiration instead.
Okay. I'll take that. I have a D8, if I recall.
Yes, Warlocks have D8s.
Cool, because I never remember what my health is. Of course, I get a terrible roll.
So it's a 5. Plus coin, plus whatever thing you have.
Holy shit, I have so much health with Draconic Resistance.
Yes. Yes, you do, because it was retroactive.
I have 71 HP.
We made a command about it. It's a joke. It's a running gag. Like, you broke everything.
What the fuck? It just updated. It was supposed to be like 62, and then it just jumped because the Draconic one finally kicked in.
So everybody saved the
Yep, it's on D&D Beyond.
Mm-hmm. So I'll update all your character sheets. Cool. And I also redid the token so we can see more of the face of the character. So Andy is closer up for the overlay. I have a hard time with my English today.
Blah, 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 blah. What are you trying to say? Overlay?
My ovaries are all over.
Oh, my ovaries. My ovaries.
Overlay. Good.
Overlay. Okay.
So let's update these character sheets. And then we'll be on our way.
This is why I drink a guru before every game. Or during. To help not call an overlay my overlay.
Fine, you just do it with pride, with your entire chest.
Yeah.
Okay.
I updated my ovaries.
Did I fucked up?
I wish I could update my
I fucked up.
Man.
D&D.
If there was a way to update your ovaries, I think there'd be a line all the way across the continent.
So sorry, Foundry will reload because D&D Beyond Importer was not put it inside the magnificent setup. So, how was your weekend? But more seriously, when you wake up the morning after,
Put a little makeup.
I want to do.
Dermot is one of the first who actually wake up and try to cook a little something. Like, he had some spare woods and stuff to, like, do a little campfire in there. Even if it's the water, it's like, it's a bad idea. I better keep it small. But it's still the smell of food that is waking you up in this after this long rest. Oh, good morning, Andy.
Oh, morning, Dermot.
You okay? Sleep
well, yeah, all things considered, you know, made friends with ghosts. That was a great day yesterday. Finally killed an Aboleth and everything, you know. Just can't wait for more horrors today.
I haven't slept much.
Yeah, I'm guessing you're worried about your friends, huh?
Yeah. It's pretty shitty.
You know, we'll go get him as soon as the others are all awake and that we have a way into the Netherdeep. Just as we promised, you know.
Yeah, no, I knew you'd keep your word. It just... You know, I'm usually the one to always keep them alive. And since they're not there with me, I... It's okay. They're gonna be fine, right?
Yeah, I mean, I've seen them fight. They're all pretty strong. That's true. Sure, you're there to heal them, but I'm sure they're with the appropriate supplies.
Yeah.
And they're probably kicking ass right now, and we'll get in there, and there's gonna be nothing for us to do except just grab them by the collar and drag them back out, right?
I don't think they want to go back out. They really wanted to see through the end with this election.
Okay, well, let's say we encounter Elixion. We can grab him by the collar too and drag him back out. That way there's gonna be no reason for them to stay in there, right?
I love how you think, Candy. It's reassuring.
Yeah, my mom always said I was super smart.
Is that bacon?
Yes, you want some?
Squish Frost should stop with like drool going all the way down his face.
Yes, yeah. I kept some from before going, and since I'm the one that have the bag of old egg in the group, it stayed dry, so it can still, well, dry, not wet with all the rest of the stuff. So that's me, like, here, and you just throw a piece. Your way.
Good morning.
Morning, boy, the Bowen.
That was refreshing.
It's very comfortable.
I know you like more fruits, Mother Bowen, so I kept, like, this melon for you.
Oh, this smell is good. It's probably ripe. Good choice, thank you.
Always.
I hear food. Oh. Is there food?
Bacon!
Someone's away.
Ah.
All right, everyone, just eat your fill and then we head out. Because I promised Dermot, you know, he's worried about his friends. Yes, but first thing first, I would like to take a very short moment with each of you before we go on this journey, because it's a very big one ahead of us. Andy, can I borrow you for a couple minutes?
Yeah. Pep talks, right?
Yeah, personalized pep talks.
Yeah, my favorite part of the day.
So she just take you apart from group, go like a couple meters away. And be like, so she looks at you from head to toes. How are you doing? I know you take care of a lot of others. You check on everybody's. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good, all things considered. I mean, we kicked that giant fish's ass yesterday, and we didn't lose anyone.
Yes, you
did. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty confident. And
yes, feeling good about yourself?
Yeah. I mean, I'm feeling even stronger than I used to, for some reason.
So that's my big, tough guy. I like it.
Yeah. I can just imagine her like just going like
Yes, it's like a coach, football coach. It's almost doesn't give it a little slap when he goes back to the room.
There's a slap on the ass. You go.
You go, my boy.
You go, my boy. You got this.
Yeah, you've got a way to cheer us up, Mother Bowen. I hope you're doing all right too.
Oh yeah, it's my pleasure. All right. You bricks, my magnificent little goblin. Come here.
What'd I do?
Nothing wrong, I swear. Just being you. All right, come here.
Grabs a piece of bacon, walks over.
You see Dermot, like, laying through Timber and squishing, like, I think being him is something bad, but it's okay.
Of course, so, I am master of evil.
Rix, how are you feeling today?
Fine. I'm fine.
Fine is not good enough for me. So, I want you to do good. I want you to do great today. So,
but I like doing bad. What is this doing good business?
But if you want to do bad, you have to do it good.
That makes no sense.
All right. So tell me, you have a good night of rest? No nightmares? Yes.
No.
Okay. Nothing on your conscience?
I mean, I do want to destroy some things, but I feel like that's just going to happen today.
Okay. Okay. That's good. Good opportunity for you. All right. So everything is in order with you?
I mean, yeah.
Well, that's
probably the thing I should do before we leave. But anyways, I can wait for a moment.
Should I do an insight check on this?
Not really. Okay. You can, but it's something you need to do before we leave.
Well, she's definitely, like, watching you, so it's going to be an insight check on this.
Okay.
All right. So, with this bad roll, I still have 19, so... What do I perceive from you?
That there's definitely something he must do, but he's kind of grumbling about it.
Aww.
As to the why, that's a okay. Bit deeper than an insight check can say, but
yeah, but the she can feel there's a little something, but okay. Well, you know, Briggs, if there's anything, we are a team. I know you like to do all your games, but I do believe you understand we work better as a group to support your majestic power, right?
Yes, that's noted.
Okay, so if there's anything, just know there's your full team behind you today.
Yes, that's a little awkward, but sure.
All right, I'll take it. Go back to your bacon then.
Okay. Good talk.
He's just gonna walk away and be like, yeah. Finger guns.
All right, Tembo.
Oh, okay.
You see one of the pillar. No.
You're in trouble now.
Oh, I'm taking my favorite for the last.
Oh crap!
Andrew's just looks heartbroken.
I think that means she has more things to say.
Oh, all right, Timber. How are you today?
I'm doing fine.
What's the matter with fine, you guys?
Fine's not good. I'm doing okay.
Okay, what can I do for you this morning to make you feel great instead?
Just don't be in any kind of danger, okay, Motherborn? You're important to me.
My safety is what bothering you right now. That's what's on your mind? Oh, Timber, you're so sweet. But look, I'm a big, tough cow. See? I'll be fine. Plus, I have this new shield that the group found.
It's the same for me. It's corrupted shield, but shield.
Yeah, well, if I tell you, I'm going to be careful and thoughtful today. Would it make you feel better?
Yes, and watch on Squash, of course.
All right. Perfect.
Okay, I'll go back to my bears.
All right. And she's going to come back to the group and squish squish.
Ah.
Can we have a nice talk for a couple of seconds, please?
Squish is just going to subtly go and take another piece of bacon and then just follow behind.
Okay, all right. So there's a reason indeed why I keep you for your last. I wanted to have a heart-to-heart conversation with you this morning. Because I'm sorry for what happened yesterday between both of us.
I'm sorry too. I kind of blew up.
Yeah,
in a different way than I did before on you.
So I do believe that in my sense, maybe you're sometimes you don't feel as much recognition as you maybe would like in this group.
Maybe.
Yeah, well it was a bit my feeling because I know you do give your all. It's not always easy because, well, danger is a bit bigger for you, but you try to do great. You try to support the group a lot, and sometimes it costs you. And I know that this group and even myself, sometimes we don't always take the best decisions, but I know it's always from a good intention. So I'm sorry if sometimes you don't feel like we see you enough.
I don't know what to say.
Well, just know that, like, even if sometimes we're not on the same line, I'll always got your back, okay?
I'd say I'd have your back, but it's more like I have your shins.
I'll take it.
Okay. All right.
Let's start this. And she offers you a fist bump.
Squishwash has extremely bacon greasy claws and just like shoves one claw into his mouth as he goes to like fist bumps.
All right. Let's do this then.
And we go back.
All right. So you can give me that roll of yours.
Yes, sir. It's supposed to
be defeat you haven't used in a freaking long time.
I know. Okay, let's go with this.
Actually, your feature. Oh, you rolled a 3.
Oof.
Sorry. Yeah. So a 15. I think it gives you guys a 1, 2, 3. Well, you have a +6 temporary HP.
That's
for the day.
Something.
I'll take it.
That's a lot.
Yes.
HP. Oh wait, my hit points haven't updated.
No.
Yes,
my
I am. I'm updating it right now.
Oh, okay. Just making sure.
Oh, I have a.
If your module reset, be careful not to like erase or cache.
Yes, no, I've unchecked all the little marks. Remove the equipment, weapons, and currency. Cannot read properties of undefined reading 0.
Hey.
Why? Foundry, you're being
updating Foundry is great.
Yeah, clearly.
See that?
Ah, there we go.
It worked?
Yeah, I have my stuff up to date.
Damn.
It says level 0, but, you know, I'll take it.
It says level 0.
I'm still level 9.
I love your trustful odd view of things.
Yeah.
Oh, hang on. I don't have any features now.
Oh. Okay, then I think there may be a problem.
Wait. Why? No, you still have your features, as I see. Since I refreshed Foundry earlier, you would have to...
I'll refresh it.
Refresh also a whole lot of you. Because I see all the features over there.
Let's see. Oh, I'm back to level 9.
Why, it's not working.
That's better than 0.
Yeah. I have features now, at least.
It's 9 levels better than 0.
I'm sure we
I'm also level 9.
We can do fine with level 9.
Cannot read properties of undefined reading 0 again.
For everyone?
No, that's only for Randy for now. Let me check with yours. Mm. Timber.
Be gentle.
Never. Default. Nope, same for you. Error importing character, attempting rolling back, see console F12 for details. And I don't know how to read this. Okay. Let's see if I can do... Okay, let me check on D&D Beyond. What's the actual, just maybe redo the links where you have your characters. Here, I think it's the same. Handy. No, it's the same. Start import. Default.
Sorry about that.
Cannot read properties or undefined reading 0 again.
It's a module interfering. It's just you have to find which one. Yep. You have anything that works with sheets?
Nope. Not that I've set up. D&D and Beyond importer, combat tracker disposition. I removed everything else there. Also, two maps module. This save module reload. But it was the same also, Timber, when I tried to add the other one. What was the module I was trying to add? The dice roller thing?
Uh-huh.
Let's make it easier. I'll try another one, so we'll just have to deal with the...
But we can always manually update for now.
Here, it's not working.
Also, try and import it in mine and then export. I haven't touched my Foundry in forever.
Let's try to re-import Andrus. Nope, cannot read properties of undefined reading 0. So yeah, we'll probably have to. Click back to a older version of this magnificent little thing. What the fuck? The character sheet's all messed up.
Uh-oh.
Reloading to see if it's still there, but having a little bit of an issue here. So everybody had the 6 temporary HP from mid-qual, required installed at least version. Okay. Okay, character sheets are okay. We'll keep them level 9 for now, because where you're going right now, it doesn't change a lot with the level that you'll have for the first part of this place. So after this little chit-chat all around, and talking to each other with Mother Bowen to have a great day with her caretaker feet, you'll be able to go on with your day. Dermot's still a bit tense, but he seems to still have a high spirit.
So, sorry, Mr. Ghost. How are we supposed to proceed?
In Squish, yes?
I think I have an idea.
Then how?
So Andy and I tried to get into this door before that is covered with rubium stuff, and it wouldn't let us in, and I think it hurt Andy. So maybe if we take the necklace there, because we think that's the key, it might open the way.
I mean, it's possible.
It's on the other side of that wall. That wall. Up some stairs.
Yes, well, we can go over there, for sure.
I mean, unless the ghosts know, and then
maybe. Yeah, I mean, are the ghosts okay with us going up there?
Well, you opened. It was at this place behind.
Yes.
Going up there, it's the statue of the Archheart, Karelin, and Mother Bowen's been there and received a blessing from it.
No, not the... No, because didn't she go here?
Yeah. You said it was just on the other side of that wall. Yeah,
yeah, towards that way.
Oh, I thought you were talking about stairs.
Yeah, going up the stairs behind. Like... The other stairs, not the stairs inside the temple.
The ones
the stairs inside the water.
If the stairs are in the water, can they still be called stairs?
Well, they're still stairs.
Yes, you don't have to necessarily be able to take them up for them to be stairs. They're part of a building, even if the building is flooded.
Like, a door is a door, no matter where it is.
Exactly.
Even if it's not on its hinges. It's still a door.
Yeah.
That rose definitely could have moved over on. Hold Jack up.
That's a deep cut now. You realize how old that is now?
I know. I watched the Titanic, like, 3 days ago. Like, not even, like, two of them. I'm mad again, okay?
I don't know. For some reason. Not sure I noticed.
The only part that will forever matter of that movie is the guy hitting the propeller. That's it.
You know what? That's fair.
So you're saying that with the rhodium weapon, we would be able to go through where you went before?
Either with the rhodium weapon, or if Mother Bowen's necklace is the key like I thought it was... I think it is. It might be the way to open the door, or we need to use the rhodium weapons to clear the rhodium from it. So you should use the key. I don't know. It's kind of covered.
Well, maybe the weapons. Well, wait. Did the ghosts bring back the great axe for me yet?
Yes. Okay. I'm adding it to your inventory right now.
Okay. Oh, well, here they come right now, holding a rhodium great axe for me. How convenient.
They went through the night to catch it, so it's actually already there. Andress, inventory, add.
I'll need the rhodium sword added to mine.
I'm also just realizing I don't have the rhodium.
Are you going to use it, Beeps?
Oh, okay. I thought it was like if we have it on us, if we roll a nat one, no matter what.
Yes, like you have it on you, no matter what. It's just that for that, there's no problem. That it's just a saving throw that you'll have to roll. So you don't need the actual weapon to be on you. Just consider that if you roll a nat one, you might have to roll something else.
That's easier then.
Okay, like just you'll then have to remind me about it because I will forget. Also, thank you.
And Squish have the D4 for now some name. The full name of Squish is Squash. Squish Squash.
Squish Squash. Because that's the sound bugs make underneath.
It's also the sound he makes when he gets killed a surprising amount of times.
Specifically.
What's the number?
Nine times.
It's not that bad.
I'm surprised it's not more.
Yeah, you know what? I was expecting more.
So was I, honestly.
I think you got off to a really fast start and then just kind of tapered off with time.
Yeah, I stopped being so suicidal.
You also gained more HP.
Who would have thought? Who would have guessed having more HP means you can survive?
Crazy thought.
Don't worry. Bigger HP means bigger monsters.
I mean, I don't have the lowest HP anymore. My big ol' 71.
That's true. So we're going to that red thingy that it's crawling all over. I think you'd pass by.
I think it's a door, so probably. What does everyone else think?
Yeah, we could. We're there already. Wow. What do you know?
Wow.
I mean, are you really ready for the day?
Those ghosts are really
speedy. So let me show you what it looks like. But first, how everything goes. You approach this large structure, but let me remove the walls so you can see.
Oh.
It's not open. When Mother Bowen approach, all these red corals and veiny texture still all over this palace.
Ew.
There's not even a trace of when Andy strike it.
Well, this looks promising.
Whoever their decorator is, should be fired. Like, on the spot.
Have you tried with the rhodium weapon on them?
Well, we haven't tried yet, no, because kind of ended up here by accident, and then, yeah, I tried hitting the door, but didn't really do anything.
It's like those big red thingies that look corrupted, so.
I have a question, Fred.
Yes.
Does this remind me of a vision at all, like, of my vision at all that I had a while ago?
You can give me an intelligence check.
Let's check. Come on. A two. So no, it does not.
You're trying to remember. The only thing you know, nothing in visions could have helped you with the whatever said. What? Maybe something that someone told? Said something about this? So, I'll go. I'll try it out. I already have my hammer. And we're here for my friends anyway.
Okay, but be careful, Jinx.
Yeah. It wouldn't do for you to die right now. You're trying to be a hero, Dermot. A hero.
We could try to put the necklace up against it first, maybe.
Well, one or the other, we're going to have to try them out.
So, which one's going first? To try the attempted necklace or our friend Dermot?
Mother Bowen looking at Dermot. Dermot's looking at Mother Bowen. Oh, I'll try it first and you get invited back if something bad happened, right?
Don't worry, I got your back.
Alright, I'll try that then. So, Mother Bowen's gonna go at the door with the necklace. Am I supposed to fit it somewhere? Going through.
Doesn't seem to have any space there.
Well, she's gonna just apply it on the surface of the red thing.
The new emerald seems to be shining a bit brighter, but it seems to be more of resisting to this crimson energy more than doing anything towards the door.
Yeah. It's crimson energy. So, let's go, boys. Let's axe it down.
If you can all stand back, just in case.
Right.
So, you like, even when you are still close, you push you a bit further, Dermot. With your passive perception, your passive insight, Mother Bowen, you know that there's something about Dermot. He seems to be... He was already tense, but it was... He's pushing you all back to 60 feet of this door, just to be sure. So don't worry. I'll take care of it.
All right, she's gonna be ready to dash if anything.
Did you?
Dermot.
When
you be careful, right?
Mother Bowen, I'll let you an intelligence check.
Oh shit. That's not good. That's not good.
Dumb stat intel. Ba 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 ba.
That's dumb stat.
Not dump, but 15. Whoa! 15.
Hey.
Enough to remember that you remember now when you were at the surface with Dermot, when he came to your quarters at the Temple of the Mentor. He said that Io and the others, he knew that the others would be hurt. Because when you strike it with a Rudum weapon, yes, it opens a door, but it gives a crimson blast all around. So that's why he would be pushing you away further than this 60 feet. Oh.
Okay.
And he hesitates because he knows he's going to be armed in the process.
Yeah. Well, I'm trying to see if there's something I can do for him.
Okay. Here we go.
Are you okay with that? What's gonna come afterward? Maybe we can try to shield you, protect you, or something to help, you know?
What do you mean?
Well, you told us that there's gonna be like a blast from this, right? That's why you're pushing us away.
I hope you forgot. Well, yeah?
Yes, so that's why maybe you would like more preparation? If we can check if we can give you more protection? From what's gonna happen there?
But
you
when you had the jewel, Well, when we had the jewel, it was the whole group that had the visions. Remember, mm-hmm. Timber? Since you charmed the IO, yeah, you were part of it.
That's true.
Maybe if the whole lot of you try with the necklace altogether, instead of just Mother Moen.
I mean, how would this work, all of us together? Do we all just, like, touch it?
I don't know, like in the theaters, like the power of friendship stuff. Holding hands, I don't know.
I think when I had the amulet, only I got the vision.
Well, I mean, Mother Bowen, if you want to try again, I can stand next to you and just kind of, and he just puts his hand on her shoulder.
How about we try it before trying risking Dermot life, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, he'll just stand there with his hand on her shoulder.
So who's following up or not following up?
Well, if you're not going in, she's going to glare at you. Yeah, she's not really giving you a choice, guys.
I'm trying to think of how... I guess Squishwash would, like, try to climb up Mother Bowen and onto her arm.
Yeah, sure.
So that way he can also be, like, pushing against the amulet.
All right, she'll pick you up.
Or, like, yeah, because your arms are a lot longer. So, yeah, Squish would have to, like, be climbing down your arm a little. It's fine. Like a cat.
Come on, Bricks, at the front.
All right. On this, please, Bricks. I can't do it without you.
Okay, you don't have to lay it on that thick. Starting to doubt the sincerity now. Squeezes his way in. Okay.
All right.
So you're all going together. And then this time... Something else happened. Let me just switch this. Let's see if that music works. The barrier right in front of you seems to crackle. And the veins are... pulling the red crimson, while the emerald sapphires and the whole amulet shine bright with holy light. And you just see the thing, the rift going open. And let me reveal the whole map to you of this place.
Ooh.
Well, I mean, I was kind of right.
Well, that's a big hole.
And since you didn't strike with a rhodium weapon, no deflagration happens.
We're smart.
The smartest.
Well, I was half right.
As well, there's this, it was a team effort. Where you don't see through what this breach is, but the current is actually pushing through this breach towards you. The water of this whole place coming out of it.
Well, last one's in a rotten egg. Squish is just gonna push off Mother Bowen and start swimming towards it.
How uncouth.
I'm gonna race him swimming because I'm a sea elf.
I know about that. I have a swimming speed.
We all have swimming speed now.
Yep. So you're all with incredible speed that you didn't know you had in yourself, swimming underwater. And you go through that breach. And let me activate the map to the Netherdeep.
And we die.
Go through and fall directly into lava.
Literally.
Oh, wait. I didn't do walls. Lol.
Well, I don't see everything.
Yes, so there's at
least one. Oh, there, yes. Okay.
Ta-da!
Oh, jeez.
All right. But the moons also switch a bit. When you're going in this deep dive. Of the Nether Deep. Hands out. Show players. The music has a bit of a hard time loading. You can do it, Foundry. I know it's new music to you, but... even if I preloaded it. Motherfucker. You worked earlier. You better work now.
Now, why would it work? Would it
the moral of the story, people, never, never update your foundry.
Apparently.
Here. So here.
Oh, there you go.
So this is what it looks like when you go down.
Oh, okay, hello.
Oh, look, it's friend-shaped at the bottom.
Who are these people?
I mean, didn't we almost die last time we have to go through something complex as that?
Yeah.
Well, it was not war, right? There was not war.
So right there. You burst from the planar rift that didn't plunge into deep, cold water. And in an immediate feeling, you feel your skin, your muscles being pushed towards inward, getting crushed. And for a millisecond, you think you're about to die from this pressure. And then you see the rhodium weapons and the emerald, the amulet that you have on yourself, that seems to be... and then the pressure stops from all of that. The pressure in the Nether Deep, like said, is deadly. And this fucking music's not working.
Everyone okay?
Yeah. Everything's fine.
You're floating 10 feet above the floor of a cavernous pit. The rift at your back. Two enormous statues have settled into the seafloor at awkward angle. Each statue is missing its head, and one of the statues is an outstretched hand that looked like it might grab anything that get too close to it. Covering the statue or clinging to the walls are crystalline tendrils that shed dim light. Eerie red light. A 10-foot high tunnel at floor levels out of this sunken chamber, which has patch of seagrass growing everywhere. But you're not alone. From under your feet, you see this large serpent that you faced on the other side.
Oh, it's the friendship.
This slithering blood fin crawling towards you and then sprint. And this is when we are roll for initiative.
Let's see how
this comes up.
I have advantage now on this, right?
Yes, you have advantage. Here, where are this creature? Search. And let's see how they roll for initiative. You only see two little lights coming from a bit further in the deep hands of this place.
And sorry, you had to reload.
Reload? Okay.
Yeah, we're good.
Here.
Holy fuck, they're fast. Holy fast fuck, they're fast. Fuck
boy.
Yep.
That's the fuck boy is right.
Slick as fuck boy. And then let's go here. Let's use the old music from first game. So we're starting with the Slytherin Bloodfin. And it's going for, nobody's wounded. So give me, so 1, 2, Andy, 3, 4 are bricks, and 5, 6. Our friend, well, it's going to be Andy anyway. So it's going to rush and go to try to bite our fighter. With the 18, I don't think it works.
It doesn't hit, no.
All right. It just, you're just swirling like, oh, okay, everything's fine. And then you just recognize the swirl of this tail that slapped you so many times the day before. And you're just like, oh, no, coming to you. And talking about the tail attack, it's going for a tail to our friend Squish Squash.
No.
Natural one. Oh.
No.
So it's just...
No.
It came to bite Andrus, and Andy just put his hummol inside of his mouth and just... And when it's trying to slap Squish, he pulls on the hammer, and you just see the tail going in really past the face of Squish Squash. And we're going to follow up with the Light Devourer. Mother Bowen, you're on deck.
Yep.
This creature is coming towards... Oh, well, the closest one is Andy, again.
Okay.
And he's trying to bite twice. So once. Mm-mm. Not enough. Whoa. Calm down. So 12 to hit doesn't work.
No.
And he's trying to bite a second time. Again, not enough. So you just see this creature being, you just see the light at the beginning, but afterwards you just see this large maw. And you're happy to wear such a heavy armor because it is not able to pierce it with his teeth. And we're following up with Mother Bowen. Andrus, you're on deck.
Yes, so she's going to be using Sacred Flame on the light Eater. That's adding
all right.
A friend.
Go for it.
Yes, sir. Let's gut slap this thing. With the 10 radiant.
All right. Let me see if I succeed on my dexterity saving throw. No. So I suffered a 10 radiant damage. But you see that it fizzles. Well, yes, what you're going to say?
Oh, but I'm also a blessed striker. So it's going to take another D8 radiant because it got itch.
All right. Roll for it. For a total of 11 radiant damage. Ooh. As you see that this energy, all the light fizzle out. And you just see all the red dots on his back emanates radiance. And you see his mouth, his teeth turning bright white with crimson energy.
Oh, okay. Now we know where it gets its name from. Sorry, guys.
So.
Greg.
You couldn't know. It's fine.
And he does emanate lights all around him.
They were not wearing name tags.
Well, guys, don't hit testing with light.
So right now, we're going to Endy. After it's light devours, Quish, you're on deck.
Okay, so just a quick question because I'm looking at the map here.
Yes.
This statue over here.
Yes.
It has like a spear, is that correct?
It have a really long spear, yes.
Because what I kind of want to try... I'm going to start that over, my brain short-circuited. What I want to try to do is hit it with my maul and use my crusher feet to push it back towards that statue and hopefully maybe impale him on that spear.
All right. So make your attack.
Okay.
You're going for the light devourer, right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
That is a 15 to hit.
15 hits.
Awesome.
For a total of 11 bludgeoning, he suffers the damage. And... crush your feet towards this thing.
Yeah.
So roll me a
d10. And he just goes like, lights out! And baseball bat swings at it. And a d10. That so is a 6.
You'll take 6 more piercing damage. And you'll make a strength saving throw. To see if it's impaled. It is. So you strike it straight to the face and you just see this large fish that is now burning bright. And that's it for... Well, no, it's only your first attack.
Yeah, so I'm just going to swim up to him. And I'll stay within range of the blood fin, so it shouldn't be taking any attack of opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll hit the light devourer again.
Okay. Natural 20.
I'll take that.
Roll me the sweet damage.
Yeah.
For 26, because I corrected with the software. Because at the beginning, we were maxing the critical dice on the damage. So, total of 26 bludgeoning damage. So, you impaled it, and while its mouth goes open to try to strike you, you just whack-a-mole his face again back towards the spear, and it just peers down just a bit further. Just for the crit, I'll increase the DC by 1 of his dexterity, of his strength check to get out.
Awesome. And then as a bonus action, I will, of course, summon my echo right over here.
All right. Is that your turn?
Yep, that's my turn.
Light devourer, the one on the right. The only having this small light in front, not burning bright like the other. We'll go to one of the three over here. So 1-2 Dermot, 3-4 Mother Bowen, and Timber, 5-6. Well, we'll go for Dermot. Nom nom nom. And he's going to bite twice. Oh, this time for a 19. No, the 19 to hit. Does it hit? Nope. So you see Dermot. You see this mouth going, and you see him getting swallowed whole. But then you see his little structure going out, getting out of this mouth with his plate armor, unarmed, because you see all the scratch of the teeth all over his armor. And that's the first bite, because you have a second one. Oh, this time it hits.
Yes, looking
for
good.
For 27 piercing damage. All right. Dermot. No, not this time. Then you see you start to bleed and it floats. And you see the Bloodfin Serpent just turning his head towards him. But now we're going for Squish Squash.
I can't share a space with the Echo, can I?
Nope.
Fuck.
This is a halfling trait.
And that's a wall?
Yes.
Fuck. I'm going to have to take an attack of opportunity then. And I'm going to move out here.
All right, so the Bloodfin tries.
Well, if I want to use any of my spells, I'm going to have to.
All right. All the fumbles tonight, fuck's sake. I can't even use a d4. Because it's failing so hard. So you just... And you got distracted with the blood coming up in the water with Dermot. It's like... And Squish, what are you doing?
Works for me. I want to check something real quick. Okay. I'm going to also be using sorcery points.
Okay.
And I'm going to force disadvantage onto the... what is it called? The slithering bloodfin.
All right.
Yeah. So I'm you heightened my your spell.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Squish is gonna just go. Sorry, fake Andy. And I'm going to. Wait, how do I turn this?
I understand that you're taking the bloodfin and.
Yes, and it's gonna hit Andy anyway, or the fake Andy.
Yeah,
because I'm seeing if I can. I want to see if I can try to cone of cold it, but I don't remember how to change.
It's to control you when you take the template. You hold control to spin it.
Control. Ah. Oh my God! What is happening?
I'm spinning it.
Oh, thank you. Because I think I worked it out where I can angle it up a bit more. To not get Andy.
I mean,
right now it doesn't get handy because you see the small blue squares. Andy, the square under Andy is not blue.
Okay, yes.
So yeah,
cool.
Both of them
so
are in the cone.
Yeah,
cold.
So my Echo will make Constitution saving throw, and it uses my stats.
Yes, but it will suffer half damage, I think, if it's
Yep. So it's 38 cold damage.
Well, it fails it anyway, so... Goodbye.
Goodbye! So that's a Bluffin for 14. And the Lightfish for 11. So both of them failed. So suffer the 38...
And I wanted to also be focused on the light one, because I'm hoping It would just help freeze it in place more.
It's already grappled, so he's moving to zero.
Make it harder for it to get out.
Give me a charisma check.
Oh! No, that's not my character. That is. Charisma?
Yep.
Check?
Yeah, just a stat.
That's a nat one.
You're trying to form a thicker layer of ice around it, but it's it's mostly the shard that pierced his skin. You sadly weren't able to cover it in that place.
Yeah. I'm going to also move up one more. Wait, no, because I'll probably get another turn. No, I'm good here.
You're good here.
I'm not moving.
Cool. So, with all that, we're going with... Where is the combat tracker? Thank you. With the Brex the Magnificent!
Whoop! So, I'm going to attack the Bloodfin with Primal Savagery.
Oh, no.
I'm going to stab it with my fingernails.
With 26 to hit, it works. With 16 acid damage. He is stuck badly injured after even one round. All right.
Deserves it.
So, with all that,
Bricks? Scoop by Andy.
Scooping by Andy. All right. So, we're going now with Timber.
I will cast Bless on Andy, Bricks, and Motherborn.
All right. Spells.
Now I'll have my spirit throw a flame seed at Big Dude.
You said Bricks?
Bricks, Andy, and Motherborn. All the ones in front of me.
What does your blessing look like?
It's been a while since I last cast this. Yeah, I'm trying to remember. It was some kind of reddish, whitish light.
Yeah.
That dances around a little bit, faintly around everyone. And if 24 hits, what the heck? What did I roll? Like,
yeah.
8 fire damage, so 4.
For the Bloodfin?
The big one, yeah.
Yeah.
And that is my turn.
Alright. So, it is a new turn. The Slithering Bloodfin will move closer here since there is no more echo. And will do an attempt to bite Dermot. Oof. But I have advantage to that. So let's see. Okay. So it was only the first 17 of piercing damage. So you see Dermot getting bit. Okay, I'm surviving. And you don't see the serpent behind him and just... And Andrus, yes?
I want to take my reaction to bonk the... big serpent.
Do you have to be within 5 feet or he have to be within 5 feet of an eye?
It says when a creature within 5 feet of me makes an attack against a target other than me.
Perfect. So you go for Sentinel.
Yeah. Bonk. Oh my god, that was awesome. Almost an 18.
Almost a great bonk.
But almost doesn't count. So he bit, and now this little creature is grappled, restrained, and I will use...
Technically, would she be able to use the blessing on this roll?
It's already on. If you see the little icon on her, I've put it in the foundry, and the D4 is on.
Oh, it's already applied.
The 14, yeah.
Sorry.
And I rolled a 1 on it, too. It's...
I'll cry with you then.
And as a bonus action, the prerequisite is to be grappling a creature. I'm swallowing Dermot.
And you just see, you were just a hand with the warhammer and just nothing more. So that was it. Wait a sec. Did Dermot act? He's not in the initiative.
Start over.
Oh. Poor Dermot. It's just a costume.
It would have been last, so he would have healed himself. Let me just cure third level. Ah. my Kebaker came out with that ach. So he's healing back 9. So at the beginning of its turn, it will take damage. But also, right now, Andy, you're receiving a tail attack from this Slithering Bloodfin. And going straight above your head with your aquatic elf form. And then this Light Devourer will do a strength check to get out of this grappled thing. Oh, he succeeds. And he go right in the middle. And you see even the Bloodfin turns his head and like... because something bad's about to happen. It's called Radiant Discharge.
Uh-oh.
Boom.
So everybody around 20 feet radius, that means everybody, give me... DC yeah, shit, 15 of Constitution.
Saving throw?
Saving throw, yeah. Constitution.
Oh my god, I made it.
Nailed it.
Alright.
I don't know how I made it, but I made it.
So everybody that fails, 20 radiant damage coming from that burst. Half for the one who succeeded. But you know what's funny with this discharge? You see this other fish light up in radiant energy. His mouth going... Yes, Chris?
Yeah. It has to make a strength saving throw.
Okay.
It's within 10 feet of me and it damaged me.
Okay. For 13.
It fails, and it is pushed 10 feet away from me. 10 feet further away.
All right. So it will be against here.
And it takes 6 force damage.
Okay.
Last is gone.
You failed concentration? Removing the blast. Removed. So that was his bonus action. He's going to try to bite our friend Bricks.
Yeah. That hits.
For a 25. The hit and 22 piercing damage. And use your stats in D&D Beyond, by the way, another one in Foundry, in case you have more HP.
Yeah, the HP is already updated, so that's fine. However,
but like said, this discharge made the other Light Devourer, starting to glow, and his mouth starting to burn bright of radiant energy. So, with that, combat tracker is done. I still have another bite, and he's going for Andrus with the second one. Oh, this time for a 23 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
For 19 piercing damage. And okay. You see also
One result, though, of this discharge is that this blood fin is near death. Oh. So, now, it's Mother Bowen. Andy, you're on deck.
Yes, Mother Bowen see what's going on between the two fishes. She looks at the one that's right next to her, like glowing bright red. And she looks at a little bad fishy as she's gonna cast command. And command him to leave.
All right, nice move. So cast your spell, please.
There you go.
And we shall see next turn, because one thing that is fun about command is that they have to understand you.
Yep. We'll see. That's gonna be it. I don't really have any bonus thingy I can do, so. Except she's gonna tell you guys, go away from that thing!
Alright, is that your turn? Alright, let's go with Andy. Light devoured and squishy on deck.
All right, I'm gonna manifest my echo once again as a bonus action right over here this time.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to take a bonk at the light devourer that's right here. Let's see. 21.
21 hits.
Or 6 bludgeoning damage.
Do you push it back towards you?
Not yet, because my echo, I will use Unleash Incarnation for it to take a hit at it.
Go for it.
16?
16 hits.
Awesome.
This time for 12 damage.
Yep. And now this time the Crusher Feet will push the fish back. Yep. And I will take my extra attack as it comes to a stop right in front of Andrus. He's just going to
whoop.
Burpsy. Whack-a-mole with a 21 hits.
That hits for 9 bludgeoning.
Apply damage. It is now badly injured.
That'll be my turn. Yeah.
So it's going to be the Light Devourer on the right side. And, there's no more Dermot, because it's inside. Let me put it on the, over here. So the fish will move here and try to bite our friend Squish Squash. Natural one. That's 4 well, tonight.
So the thing doesn't speak common. Shoot.
And he's going to bite Mother Bowen. And it will not hit with a 9. Mm. So he just and then I'll use my bonus action to a Radiant Discharge. So everybody, DC 15 Constitution saving throw.
Yeah. That was almost a 20.
Oh, God.
Nope. One.
All right, bring in the damages.
It's 22.
22 radiant damage, half if succeeded on that 15 constitution. And the other fish starts to glow. And thank you, Goro. Mother Bowen's having a D4 because you look repressing a lot of dark feelings that are boiling over.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Goro. So, with that, the Light Devourer's full turn. Squish, back to you. Bricks, you're on deck.
Squish is going to look past at the one that's glowing. Mm-hmm. And Squish's claws are going to start glowing with necrotic energy. And Squish is going to be like, no. And I'm just going to point my claw at it, and I'm going to cast Blight. So it needs to make a constitution saving throw.
Nice move.
Let me see. What
at level? Your DC is 16.
It's 18.
18? Oh, well, I rolled 18 straight flush.
I'm going to... Can I spend my three more with sorcery points and impose disadvantage?
Since it is a critical situation and you would have done it even before the check, all good. So I'll go with disadvantage. It's even better.
Oh, God. Well, it's going to take... I said 88. Whatever. What? Why did I put plus 8? No. Oh, I hit the wrong thing. Haha. So ignore that. Let me just fix this.
No problem.
I thought I typed. I don't know what I hit, but I hit something. But there we go.
Oh.
That's much better.
So half of that.
So it takes half of 29.
Well, I have. And right now it is near death, but not dead. Are you doing anything else, Squish?
No, that's it. That's it for now.
All right. So now we're going with Bricks.
All right.
Timber, I'm back.
I'm just going to go attacking this guy. It's going to be the claws again.
All right. Primal savagery. Savagery is. It hits with a 22. Roll me this good acid damage and maybe you'll save the day.
Oh, that's some good acid damage.
Is it enough?
Fuck if I know.
I just you can over damage. Above him to see.
I'm still alive.
Near death.
So near death.
Ugh. It's really redder than before.
It's a normal-sized creature. Do I... You know what? I've dealt damage to a creature. He's larger than me. Fury of the small. Four more damage.
And four. What was missing? So how you want to do this, Bricks?
I'm just going to, with my extended claws, clamber onto it and just start poking out every little dot on its back. Just like, piece of crap!
And because of that, you see the radiant energy just getting out of this point that you're piercing, and the radiant energy just disperse instead of exploding. With the bubbles. Because you're in water.
Thank goodness I can breathe in the water. Good. Well, with that done, I'm going to... Right, bonus action, disengage, and go over here.
All right. Let's follow up with Timber.
Timber will use this Wildfire Druid channeling to... scatter and remove the heat around this guy here and cast Frostbite.
Ooh.
has to do a constitution saving throw.
That he fails.
He takes 10 cold damage, and its next melee attack is at disadvantage.
Oh, nice one.
And near the death. Guy will give it its best.
Flame sword!
And probably fail.
14 with the Bloodfin. Yes, he has more AC than that. Do you want to use your D4?
Oh, not for that.
All right.
That's my turn.
I'm trying. So, Dermot started stern within the belly of this thing. So you will take... Oof. 14 necrotic damage.
Hey, it's better than the radiant.
True.
Act.
Dermot is now badly injured. And from inside, you will try to strike it, I guess. Since he's restrained and blind, so a disadvantage. Still hit at 16 for 12 bludgeoning damage. And an extra 2d6. Of psychic. And then roll again. Oh. You rolled a 1.
That disappointed. Oh.
With a rudium weapon, so you have to do a charisma saving throw.
Yep. No, Dermot, no. Dermot, no.
And he fails. So from inside, like, you see this, come some crimson energy coming out from the mouth, and then. So then, you have now 1 level of exhaustion. All right. So next. Would be not the echo. No, I don't want to reroll the initiative. Come the fuck down. Remove combatant. Thank you. Top of the round. Sittering Bloodfin. Will now try to bite Andy. Now that he has something in its stomach. He was rolling a disadvantage, but 19 doesn't hit you anyway, right?
19 just hits, yeah.
So I will reroll to see if I hit. It would be 22. So yes, so the first damage, the 15 piercing, it's coming out, and you're now restrained into his mouth. And you can see Dermot, like, inside of his, like, throat down there. But he's stuck in there. So... That would be the Slithering Bloodfin. You have a tail attack. You will tail swap because you have a feat of 10 feet to on our friend Bricks. Yes?
Never mind. No.
Well, you're restrained. Well, you could still make your attack opportunity.
No. Well, actually, it has
disadvantage on that. On
both?
Well, on the first one, did you do a disadvantage?
I did disadvantage. I rolled twice, and he rolled a 19 and a 22 to hit Enders.
Yeah, no, actually, it's because I have a new subclass feature at level 10, Shadow Martyr.
Okay.
So I can use my reaction to teleport my Echo to an occupied space within 5 feet of the targeted creature and take the attack instead of it.
Perfect. Did you use your reaction before to use your Sentinel attack?
Not on this turn.
Not on this turn? Perfect. So, do you describe me how the echoes take the hit?
So, as soon as like the tail kind of winds up and starts to swing towards Bricks, the echo would just kind of like dematerialize in a swirl of shadows and then just reappear right in the tail's path and take the hit instead of Bricks.
Perfect.
And it rolled a 27, so my echo dissipates.
Yes. but saved our friend from a 27 for 18 damage.
Yeah. Also, Brix is badly injured, so I was like...
So we're going now with Mother Bowen. Andy, back to it will be on deck.
All right, so now I have to please a chat. So I have to unleash something very dark from Mother Bowen. So she's going to look at that fish. And she's gonna talk the same language as it does and show it what is it to be a bad light user by using inflict wounds as she's gonna try to take away the light from it as it's not deserving the light.
You're not deserving the Everlight.
No. At a higher level, actually. Let's go for a level 3. Oh, she's very pissed at that fish.
Okay.
Let's go with that.
With a third level, 23. 23 hits. So give me the sweet, sweet damage.
Sweet, sweet damage. So, 3 plus 1. So, 5.
It's 10. It's 5 8? D10 plus... your yes. Wisdom modifier.
4, I think. Is it plus 4 once, right? Not for every dice.
It's just at the end, plus 4. All but right. Technically, you could click on damage with inflict wounds, too. You can roll the damage of it. No?
I don't have option for damages.
It's a pop-up if you miss it.
I missed it, so I'm just did it manually anyway. Ah! And I'm not good, so...
Want me to do it?
I'm about to do it, sir.
You can use the tray down there to click on the D10s, and, but it worked. 32 necrotic damage. This one was still unharmed. And sadly, the light doesn't go... Well, he didn't have light, so you're safe. It was the other one. But 32 necrotic damage... Coming up this large beast because Goro asked you to unleash the darkness.
Make the darkness again.
So was that your turn? You still have a bonus?
Yes, that's a lot for Mother Bowen, I can tell you. That's going to be enough.
All right. Andy, back to you. Squish your on deck after the light devour.
Well, I'm restrained, correct? So there's only one thing I can do, and that's bonk the slithering blood fin.
Yes, you can bonk a disadvantage.
Wow, that's not one.
That's a good charisma saving throw time.
But, oh, does it apply even axe. If I'm carrying? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Come on, Himbo. Okay. Okay.
16?
Do you want to use a D4?
I don't have one.
It's the first check. Like, I was like, is it already that bad? Because that's bad. That's very bad.
You gain a level of exhaustion, Andrus.
Well, I do have a thing that allows me to re-roll. Indomitable to reroll a failed saving throw. So
sounds like a good time to use it.
Yeah, I'll use that. Oh boy.
And Mother Bowen, remember the necklace, what it gives you as a reaction, what you can do.
Oh, that's worse. So, yeah, one level of exhaustion. Huh?
Let me just. You can expend one of the charge within the for a creature within 60 feet of you to reroll the saving throw.
I do have luck too. I could use my luck, you know, just
well, oof. Do you need help? I could maybe help you.
I mean, exhaustion kind of sucks, so I'll take all the help I can get.
All right, so I'll use one of my reaction, I guess, on this, to use one of the charge from the necklace to help my boy, Andrus.
Please. Please, mommy.
Yeah. Reroll. Save and throw. Save and worse. I'm sorry.
I'm so tired.
Does the one on the saving throw mean another saving throw?
No. Sorry. It does not escalate like that.
Okay, good. Good a bit. I had to ask.
I could use my luck point.
You could use your luck point.
I'll use my luck feet to reroll for the fourth time.
Four rerolls.
Fucking charisma.
Because luck really worked for you so far, right?
Yeah.
It worked. It worked out, actually. But not this time.
Yeah, okay.
And yes, Goro, this mini saving throw is called a glutton of punishment.
Yeah, I sure am. I had to roll above a 15 anyway, which, you know, so.
But sadly, it doesn't work. So you just try to defend yourself, and while you're grappling, you're just like, you just see the great axe that you have on you, the crimson energy just coming to you, and you just feel the pressure of this deep ocean crush you a bit, and this is why you're getting exhausted. You're just feeling, and really, really quickly, you start to see red rash coming up your arms. A bit like you've seen on Question. Background Academy.
I do have an extra attack, though.
You still? Do you want to do it?
Yeah.
Cool.
A disadvantage.
Whew. Close to ones.
I would have cried, I think. Well, I'll re-manifest my echo as a bonus action.
Okay.
You know what? This thing is almost dead. I'm going to use Action Surge.
What you doing?
Get more chances for a one. Let's go.
Yep. This is fine.
Oh, 23.
There we go.
Roll the damage and eight. So with all this crippling inside the mouth of this thing, how you want to do this?
Yeah! So Andrus is just kind of like struggling to get a hit in, gets zapped by the rhodium axe that's on his back, and he's just like, oh my gosh, for fuck's sake, and at some point, as he, like, winds up to hit the serpent again, like, he just knocks out a tooth by swinging upwards. And as it, like, screeches, he just jams his, like, the pommel into the throat and just manages to, like, very ungracefully kill this thing.
All right.
So I forgot something.
What do you forget?
As these guys are dying, it should have been a little bit smaller because now it's going a little bit over. As life exits and leaves those creatures, a tiny mote of flame dances above their bodies.
Creepy. But you know one thing I didn't play, and now I remember that I have to play? When the blood fin die? It's called Death Burst.
Oh, nice.
It's incapacitated. Sure, it's normal.
That's a fart, right? It just farts. That's the pink we see. It just farts pink.
Hello. Oh, shit. Why is it poisoned, though? Shit.
What's the range on it?
It's 10 feet of him, but the template is doing 5 feet. Because it doesn't take consideration that it is large. So it's technically everybody except Timber.
Well, I saved.
Am I still restrained?
Nope.
Okay, so this isn't a disadvantage.
Well,
fuck.
This is hurting.
I'm not meant to succeed any saving throw tonight.
21.
21 succeed. So have... succeed. No, if you succeed, no damage. So Andrus and Squish, you are safe.
And the two others, you take the 11 poison damage.
I am
damage.
The true magnificent one.
The sweet, sweet damage.
I'm rethinking some things.
So,
been a sorcerer.
With all that.
No, I'm rethinking things that might have helped you.
So, combat tracker, where are you? Okay. So after Andrus, well, you still have one attack and movement because you action surged. Andy.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to do anything?
I mean, yeah, I guess I'll swim over here.
Okay. And you bonk?
Yeah, that's true. I do get an extra attack because I action surged. Mm-hmm. So, bonkity bonk. Bonk, bonk.
Bonk, oh, so bonk, close bonk. To 20. 16 hits.
We'll still take it for 12 bludgeoning damage.
And he suffers it really bad. You can just move. Yeah. Do you use your crusher feet?
I will also just move. Sure, why not? I'll move my echo here and this guy to this spot over here.
All right. So it is now? It's
and my echo will be there.
What's the intelligence of that thing? 2. So it will strike at the shadow in front of it.
Uh-huh.
Since it just swarped its place and it looks like the guy you just strike him.
It does not hit.
It don't do shit.
It's about damn time you get nat ones.
It's about damn time. The fifth one of the night.
Yeah, he's hasn't been rolling all that well tonight. So,
so let me go then for Timber, right behind under me. Oof.
You know what that means?
Reaction time.
Shit. Never mind. I can't do Sentinel with my Echo.
What do you mean? Save me.
No, it's true. You cannot do. We decided.
We judged that. Yeah.
So, do you can do multiple times the saving thing of disrupting your shadow? No.
No, only once per short or long rest.
Okay. So, Timber, 26 piercing damage.
I'm fine.
Is the first damage that you receive, I think. Oh, no, no, you're not. He threw the blasts. I'm sorry.
I'm fine.
That was the second bite, so we're going now with Squish Squash.
So Squish Squash is just going to look at it and just start screaming. And I'm going to use, what is that racial thing? Grovel, cower, and beg. So now everybody has advantage on it.
So any attacks or everything, advantage on the...
Once per short rest as an action, you can cower to distract foes. Until the end of your next turn, allies gain advantage on attacks against it within 10 feet of me as long as I can see.
Yeah, so you're like...
Squish is just gonna start screaming and forcing it to look at Squish.
And you just see, like, the eyes on its back. You just see, like, eyes moving towards you. And his eyes.
And Squish might scream a little bit more because of that. But, yeah, that's my card.
All right. We're going with Brix the Magnificent.
At the start of Brix's turn, Timber will yell, "Quick, Brix, behind you. Touch the fire."
Eh?
Touch the fire.
There's a fire spirit right behind you.
Oh, that was covered by the big giant skull. Yeah, well, Brick's got touched the fire, apparently.
The flame licks you, and it feels good.
No, are you an adult?
You heal 4? Well, 10.
Well, 10.
I mean, I'll take the heal.
And the spirit disappears.
That's nice little spirits. Did it happen also with the Bloodfin that died?
Yeah, there's one here.
Okay, it's under.
I see it on top. Weird. Okay.
Good. I'll just remove it so we can see them. Yeah, all right.
But this one's gone because Briggs absorbed it.
Can you delete them?
No.
That's weird. I give you ownership. Okay. So, Briggs, you only touched it. Not even part of your movement.
Well, I'm going to Eldritch Blast.
Eldritch Blast at advantage. He will have, well, since he can swim up and down, I won't give him cover because he would have swum like a bit up to. So 25 hits.
I also ignore a half and three quarter cover.
True, you're fucking sharpshooter.
Correct.
Fine.
But I appreciate ignoring cover more.
So 12 force damage. Sweet, sweet damage. But you have more than one blast, right?
I got two blasts.
For 19 or?
Sweet damage.
Because you could have crit on the... You have advantage right now.
True. All right,
because Squish is...
Not just do another
doing
attack
what Squish
roll.
Does best.
No, all right.
Okay. So, damage.
Damage.
For 6 force damage. I deleted it, but I removed it manually.
It's fine as long as the 6 is gone.
Badly injured now.
And... Yep, that's it.
All right. It's now Timber's turn.
Should I do that? Sure. I will point the ring of shooting stars.
Ooh.
Behind it, and well, it says it needs to move within 5 feet. A bit weird. Anyway, so a ball of lightning will form itself and then hover there. The first time a creature goes around it, like 5 feet next to it. I mean, it's already there, so I don't know if it applies. Probably not. But if it doesn't, Timber will say something like, "Push it towards the ball."
No, it works.
It works instantly?
Yep. I think so.
Okay. Well, it doesn't say. It says when a creature other than you comes within 5 feet, so I don't know if it counts if it's already there.
I'll roll with it for now.
Sure. Because otherwise I wanted Andy to push. In that case it has to do DC 15 dexterity saving throw.
Saving throw. Normal. Natural 20.
Nothing happens, and the ball disappears. I think this only when it fails or succeeds. No, I think it might stay though. It says when a creature other than you comes, the spell discharges lightning and disappears. It disappears. Okay.
Okay. Well,
that was fun.
So it's now Timber, Dermot's turn.
I'll throw some flame.
Oh, true. Flame seed his face. Oh, it hits.
With advantage.
With advantage? You might get so crit. Check if you crit. Nope.
Four. So 4. That's my turn.
All right. And Dermot will... Okay. Don't fall, okay? As you watch the other one while he's bleeding from everywhere. He'll go... swim through Squish. And try to slam it twice. And you see, like he's being tired. But he's going to Iridium Warhammer. Plus 2d6. Oh, for 21. All right. And he will strike again. Oh no. You see that he's holding back his searing wrath. He's like channeling his channeling the radiant energy into his hand. He's like, oh no, it's true. And he just discharges it into the cavern. And we're now going back top of the round, Mother Bowen.
Oh yeah. All right, so two things then. First thing first, she'll summon like a big golden bell behind the light devourer that's gonna have an ominous ring to it as she casts Hold You Dead.
Oh, Mother Bowen. but it's already done, so you technically have to roll the 2d12.
2d12, right. There you go. 2d8.
He succeeds with a 16 wisdom saving throw. So no damage happens with a Toll the Dead.
All right, but still, I'm going to use a bonus action to use a mass healing word for everyone.
All right. Cast me that sweet, sweet healing.
Yes, sir. Ew. So plus 10 for everybody.
Yay. Yay.
Love that.
All right. And that's going to be the end of my turn.
All right. And we're going with Indy. Light Devourer, squish on deck.
Okay, so Andy and his Echo will move. Echo over here and Andy over here. And we're just gonna bonk. More bonks. Always bonk.
And you bonks at advantage forever because bonk. Of Squish.
So Andy will take the first. That's true. So first bonk.
21.
Bonk number 11. 1.
All
so
right.
That's 11 bludgeoning damage. Bonk number 2.
22.
That hits.
For 8.
And then Unleash Incarnation. The Echo will also take a bonk.
Take a bonk at advantage.
So many bonks.
21, it hits.
So many bonks.
So little damage. That's sad.
My god, the rolls though. 7 bludgeoning damage.
You hit. You still hit. Is that your turn?
It's something.
It is.
Yeah.
It will turn. Because it's now the Light Devourer. One attack at Andy. Automatically the damage. So 13.
Yeah, that misses.
That miss, and the other one on our friend Dermot. That also misses. So
this time I will be taking my reaction to Sentinel and hit again.
Bonk again at advantage.
More bonks. Always bonks. Now that I'm next to it. Yeah.
Oh.
All of the bonks.
But 14 just 14. Hits.
Okay, cool.
So how you want to do this, Andy?
13 bludgeoning damage. Andy and his Echo just whack-a-mole this thing until it finally expires. Just alternate bonks. Bonk, 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 bonk. And then he invites everyone to start kicking at it since we're all like surrounding it. Just bully this fish.
While it's been bonked, there's a moat that exhales out of its mouth and I'm going to grab it quickly while not trying to get hurt by the bonking. So I can heal.
Squish will not so nicely grab Dermot and start pushing him towards the other moat. Touch the fire! Do it!
Let Timber grab it. I think I better stay than him.
Timber just has one. You take it.
It disappears.
What did you get from
Dermot just awkwardly look at Squish like, I'm sorry. I didn't know it was going away. The other thing left stayed so long.
I didn't know this would happen. It's okay, next time you guys will know. They don't seem to hang around too long, but they're friendly.
What is that?
Seems they're a representation of my power when life leaves a creature.
Okay.
Now what they
That's
say.
That's dark.
Life finds a way.
So do we get out of here? Go with to this little corridor up there.
Are you okay? Who's injured?
All of us.
I mean, yeah. I am just a little bit, but I'm yeah.
Well,
should we rest this soon?
I can ask the Luxon to heal us a bit. The whole lot of us. Let me check. So let's start with
Oh, it's okay, Dermot. I'll do it if we're not resting. Are we resting or not, guys?
The Luxon doesn't give me a lot of power except this, so let me handle it.
Oh no, I'll do it, Dermot. It's okay.
And
you can both do it.
And
he
heals you. Like what you're saying, I'm do it. He's healing you, Timber. For 24.
Just heal yourselves mutually.
50. Okay.
He'll heal himself.
While they do that,
mm-hmm.
Can I send my echo into the corridor ahead?
Yes.
So I can temporarily transfer my consciousness to it. And yeah, I can. It can move to 1,000 feet away from me, so I can get the scout ahead into the corridor. So
we have
maybe I can get an idea what's.
Am I the only one who hear Ari that's lagging?
Ari's lagging.
Am I?
And you're frozen out for me.
You're the robot of the night.
So do you want to refresh OBS? I guess that's what she does.
Doing that.
while she's doing that, I'll cast Mask Cure Wounds on everybody.
Oh, that's what you were talking about. Oh, man, 3 ones.
What the heck?
But you heal...
This is a fifth level spell, come on.
Your thing about Fire Spirit, you heal 1d8 more,
I added
right?
It. It's 3d8 normally.
Okay. Oh, gosh.
We're still healing 15 times 6, so 5. Sorry. 6. That's still a lot of HP.
I'm almost full. God, I was down so much health. Holy shit. If it wasn't for my draconic resistance, I would have been squashed again.
And we would have followed tradition.
And it would have been 10. Thank God I have that extra 20 HP.
Hey, here you go, Bother Bowen. For 17.
Ooh. Oh, okay. Thank you.
Oh, bricks.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Your arm's about to fall off.
No, it's not. He says as he's like.
Oh. So that would
you
be.
You can rapid
10.
Fire them.
That would be 13 plus 4, so 17 healing. I just misclicked the thing.
Nah, that's.
Did we get our. Ari back? I don't think so.
Foundry says I'm fully healed, but I'm not. But I'm also super close, so it's fine.
Yeah.
I'm at 60 out of 71, so I'm Gucci.
All right. So, after this, let me change if the music can work.
Oh shit, I forgot I was... whatever. I forgot I had extra ice damage.
Oh.
It's fine.
Oh, we just arrived and this is pretty rough.
I hope it's not for the rest. And you see... Down at the bottom, now that you're paying attention, the corpse of one other light devourer and one blood-fed serpent.
Oh, there's more.
Wow, they're all capable, clearly.
Yeah, but you see what happened?
That seems like someone else is here.
To be fair, they might have dealt with it quicker than we dealt with these. There's always the possibility.
Let's hope so. Okay.
But I'm also going to swim down there. And I'm going to see if there's any treasure.
When you're going deeper, you see only the bodies of the floating thing that just like... But with the statues, the heads of the statues didn't fall at the bottom. There's just no head on it.
Well, that sucks. I don't think there's any treasure down here. I'll dog paddle back up.
All right. You're coming back up, and there's the only one slight small corridor. Yeah, are we going?
All
right. I think Andy was exploring with the echo.
True.
Andy, what does it look like?
Not here yet.
Well, from when I... Oh. I've been sucked in somewhere else.
Well, that sucks.
is it safe or not? Because we were sucked in here.
I'm inside the child's room.
What?
It's weird. There's like a teddy bear, a rocking horse.
What is happening?
I don't know.
I don't think it's the time to joke, Candy.
I'm not joking. Do I look like I would be joking?
I'm very confused.
No kidding.
And there's rhodium spike on the cradle line. There's toys and wooden shelves. Everything seems to be placarded with rhodium. I've been...
Are you on drugs, Andy?
No, I'm inside the shadow. I don't know if it's the shadow that's working like that.
Just swim forward.
Do I try to remove my shadow? Oh! We got Harry back.
You see me?
I see you.
Okay.
Still lagging though, but yeah.
Oh, there's a raid.
And Aspen Hark, thank you for the raid with your 8 people. They're now venturing and they've been into a bloody battle, as you can see inside on the map right now. And let me remove the little fire spirit over there with the large bloodfin serpent. Here. And, you were describing, actually, Andy, since you were not there. You went with your shadow, I remember that you were in, and you, everything just shimmered around you when you were inside the shadow, and you were into a child's room. And I'll just repeat what I've said, and just like, I don't know, guys. I'm inside a child room. There's a teddy bear on the ground. There's... a rocking horse and the cradle lined with rhodium spikes. There's shelves and there's rhodium crawling on one side. Toys and
It's just really weird. And the others were asking, what the hell was happening? Are you joking, Andy? And all that kind of stuff. It's not time to joke.
No, I swear, I'm serious. I really just look like a child's room. And maybe they have children in the deep. I don't know.
I think she's dead. Gone forever.
Yep.
Use your words, Andy.
Use vowels. That's weird, though. It's the first time we have a problem with your internet.
Oh, Montreal internet. Well, Longgate internet.
Longgate. Whoa, it's out shore. We have good internet.
We have great internet. I say as someone who's no longer in the Montreal area.
Do you though?
I mean, I have great internet. 2 hours away.
Do you?
Brussels.
I do have good internet.
This is the Mordor. All right. So what are you guys doing? We're hearing what Andy says.
Squish went in.
I went into the hallway here. Look around.
The hallway doesn't seem much. In. Doesn't look like much. Let me just... And you don't see the shadow.
We should probably stick together, all things considered. Especially if we're going to be encountering weird things like children's rooms.
Pull out a rope. My rope and tie it around me. And like, does someone want to grab onto this?
Alright. I'm going to grab onto the rope with my very little strength.
So you grab on it?
Does Bricks look like he's really trying or just very casually putting his hand on it?
I mean, I'm holding on to it. Okay. He's holding on to it. He's just like... He's just not very strong. He's like, hopefully this doesn't put tug.
Maybe someone with strength. Because I'm going to... See what's happening.
Oh, right. Okay. I'll help you, Bridge.
Big guns. Let's go.
And I'll slightly swim forward, a rope tied around my waist.
And at the beginning, this thing is only a cavern. When you're going forward, and the water shimmers around you as you're transported out of the undersea gloom and into a child's room. Simple comfort are scattered around the room's perimeter. A teddy bear overgrown with rudum, a cradled lion with rudum spikes, and a rocking horse with tendrils of rudum crawling up to one side of it. Simple toys are scattered on the floor, with more of them on the small wooden shelves. All of them are laced with rudum. Sunlight shines into the room through the two small, high windows. You hear muffled voice coming from outside and occasional dull thud. The room is 20 foot square. And there's seems to have other rooms to where you're going. And for the others, well... Bricks. There's no more pressure on the rope.
If we look forward, it just disappears?
Yep. With the same
glimmer. And the rope just dangles, or does part of the rope also disappear with him? Or...
Nope, the material just flop down, but everything, it's like if it would be tied again around him.
So if we tug it, does the rope come back?
Yes.
It's
it is a lace.
Bricks is going to pull it back and come to that knot and be like, oh, that's maybe bad.
Maybe we should hurry, just in case something happens.
I'm gonna pick up my rhodium sword and start poking at the rhodium teddy bear.
The teddy bear take you up a sword and no.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Boss battle.
Now you just see when the rhodium enter in contact with the one, you just see that there's some crimson energy that seems to be entering contact. But mostly when you have something that conduct electricity, just a little arc in between, but there's nothing much.
Hello? Hello?
Squish squash! We can't hear each other, I guess.
Nope.
Okay, I'm gonna rush in.
Timber's rushing in.
Here?
Timber follows. No, not Timber, but...
I'm just swimming towards the door. Am I still swimming
Not swimming. You're right now inside a room.
I'm gonna walk towards the door.
Okay. So, is it everybody rushing in back in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, everybody rush. Squish, you have the time to go to the door and open it. You see that... On the other side, there's a kitchen and a living area. That seems, it's a kitchen and living area, and there's another door that seems to be leading to a bedroom.
Hello? I wander out towards the closest area.
You hear the sound coming from out the windows. And all the others, you see what I've described a bit earlier. The rocking horse, the other things, the cradle lined with rhodium spikes, the little baby, and the rocking horse. And with your passive perception, Mother Bowen and Timber, you see that on the sides of the toys is carved a name, Elixion.
Wow, we are way down the memory land.
No kidding.
Oh.
Anyone does something with the... What do you see there?
The room is big enough for all of us. It's.
Yes. It's tight. But it's filled.
Prix, you're a magic user. Can you touch an object and interact with it somehow and have more information? Or is it the kind of you can do?
Do you manipulate anything?
Probably saying that while looking at the rocking horse or something like that.
Yeah, you're pushing it with your finger.
Well, rocking it a little, looking around, because I somehow found the name, so I'm trying to see if I can figure something more.
You hear inside your head.
Oh, shit.
Such a thing no longer hold a special place in my heart. But it might be worth something to you.
That's weird. Guys?
What?
I think Alexan just gave me a thought right now from those things.
A thought?
I hope the fish is not back.
Oh, God, no.
We do are in his room. Don't know how this works, though. It's like a time pocket dimension. I'm not sure.
On the other side, something happens where when you go looking out at the window, Squish,
face planted right up against the window.
You look, you see like two humans that are being attacked by like around six peoples, and you see that they have pitchforks, like peasant tools. The two folks, you one thing that you recognize is the curly hair that Elixin had. Seems to be on a older man. Looks like him a bit in the far distance. The mother have a wearline scarred face. Both have olive skin and wear simple dirt-stained garments. But they're being attacked by these peoples.
Does it feel like I could break the glass?
It's not a glass. You can literally jump through the window if you'd like.
I mean, if they're being attacked, I would like to give them some backup.
Okay.
Throw out a firebolt at one of their assailants.
All right.
Natural 20.
Holy shit.
Firebolt and a half.
So, and good world. Jesus. 30.
All right, 34. 30. You disintegrate one of the attacker. Literally, let me just check what's the stats block of this thing. Yeah. You don't disintegrate, but you almost killed it. But it is still up. And one thing you hear is like, "You have brought this throne upon us! Monsters birth monsters!" And when you burn half of the body of one of the creature, or one of the farmer, you hear one of the others scream, "No good ever comes from sheltering a child of Rudis." And this is where we'll run for initiative, but it will be a theater of the mind.
Okay.
Let me just open the compendium because I'm trying to find it.
Well, let me roll initiative. You roll.
Oh, I have to use the. All right.
Let me just do a d20 plus 2.
Activate combat. Now it should be working.
Ah. Okay. But Squish was yelling this whole time, so I'm sure everyone...
Yeah, everybody gathered pretty up quickly at the windows and the door. So I'll roll for Andy.
Damn.
So let me check up for some combat music. All right. So, right now, Mother Bowen, did you roll for initiative?
No, sorry, I was taking care of dogs.
No problem.
All right.
While Squish washed through the firebolt, would I be able to like clamber out of the window?
Yes, you would use your movement to go through, and they're about 70 feet in front of you.
I'll use my full 30 to get out there as combat's beginning.
All right. And we start with bricks. There's two windows and a door. And like I said, with the scream, you all came out and you've seen these six creatures. Tisic farmers attacking these two person.
So I started blasting. I ask no questions. I pick one and Eldritch Blast.
All right.
Well, one looks almost dead.
Well, that one first, then. The 13.
All right, 13 to hit. Let me check if it hits. Yes, it hits.
All right.
You don't have a lot.
Sweet, sweet damage. 8 damage.
8 damage. All right. You want to do another one?
Yeah, if it ain't dead, then
we'll have to fix that. With the one that had... You're aiming the one that Squish hit?
Yep.
So, it would be this. 20 hits?
Right, roll that damage. Ooh, that's 10, good damage.
They're really not in a good shape, but they're still up.
Yeah, well, that's what I got.
All right. And you see that... Well, no, we're not right now. Are you coming closer, Bricks, or are you staying inside and shooting?
I'm staying near the door. I don't got to get closer. I got range.
Perfect. And it would be Andrus' turn. Andrus would be rushing into the action, but he would only spend all of movement to reach out. No, it would actually appear its echo and try to swing twice to one of the attacker. Sixteen to hit would hit. Well, the last one, it was the last hit. He was hitting the one that's Squish smash and poof, and on the five farmers, only one left. Five left on the six. And the other hit for a 9 on the other. So I'm keeping track on the HP on the other side. All right. So. 9. We're going. Now it's the whole lot of them. You see that one of them is staying, trying to attack the two parents, and the others are rushing toward the house, the four of them. So two of them will stay on Andy, and the two others are rushing, but they're only able to do their movement, their full movement to go next to Squish. But the two on Andy's will strike with reckless attack. So 3. It doesn't want to work. For 13 damage, and check if it hits. Nope, 16 would not hit. And the second one, my advantage is not working. That's freaking weird. Not hitting. Not hitting. So the bird, you see those farmers are like stabbing in front of him. And when Squish, you got out, and Andy, you see the mother that is on the ground screaming towards your way. Where is it? Get back inside, Alex. Everything's all right. They just don't understand. And that would be them. And Squish, back to you. Dermot, then Motherbone, you're on deck.
Squish is going to try to position himself to get as many of them as he can within a 30-foot cone. Because I don't know how much farther ahead Andy was.
He went to the full... No, he was not there because it's the echo that was next to it. So the echo would be in the way, but not handy.
And how many would I get with a 30-foot cone?
3 of them.
Okay. Again,
if you don't want to hurt the parents.
I don't want to hurt the parents.
Cool.
I'm going to do this at a 4th level. Fuck it, I'll just place it there.
So
they need a con save.
So one fails. Second fails. Third fails.
So on a failed save, they take 27 cold damage each.
Mm-hmm.
And they're hindered by ice for 1 minute. Or until another creature within reach of it uses an action to break away the ice. A creature hindered by ice is speed reduced to zero.
All right.
So, since they all failed, they are all stuck to the ground. And it's actually not 27 damage, sorry. It is... I can...
Plus your charisma, I think?
Is it? Yeah.
Modifier?
Just double checking. Where is it? Oh, features. Class. Where is it? Where is it? In here. It's in here somewhere. I think it's my charisma modifier. So an extra 4.
All right. Added it. So it's going to be Dermot. Dermot's going to be rushing towards the front and will attack one of the two that is next to Squishquash with his...
Yes. It's plus 4, sorry.
With his... Rudium Hammer. And... Well, he will Searing Wrath first. Oh my fucking god.
Jesus.
He disintegrates. One of the two that you just see the Searing Light deck. No, don't hit my friend. And you just see.
Jesus.
The one right
Who's
next
Jesus?
To you.
Jesus.
I think it's a guy who walked on water.
And that's not impressive.
And changed water into wine.
That's impressive.
And with the Rudium Warhammer, he will hit the one next to you with an extra 2d6. So, plus... No, not plus 3. So, 8 plus 15 on the others. Okay. So, 47. All right. That's our friend Dermot. Mother Bowen. Back to you, Timber, next.
I'm a bit confused about this battle map, to be honest.
They are 75. They're 70 feet away from you.
We're doing okay. theater of mind.
Well, I'm only third. Oh wait, did you kill both of the ones on me?
No, only one of them.
So one of them's within 30 feet of you.
Okay. How about I let you guys do the fight, and I'll take care of the parents. Because from what I see, there's someone hurts on the floor.
Yes, in the far distance, the one that it is at 70 feet, there's still one beating them up that is attacking them.
Yeah, you're talking about the parents?
Yes.
Okay, and the parents are 70 feet up away from us right now.
Exactly.
Okay, do I reach that though? Well, otherwise I will go forward to try to at least...
So you're moving and dashing towards them, dodging the enemies?
This is... I just want to see the... Oh, gosh. That's a touch. Sorry, I didn't get that in mind. I just want to be able to kill them a little so they might survive a little. Okay, what I would be doing would be, yeah, I could be dashing and use a healing word as a bonus action.
All right.
On one of them.
Okay, the father seems to be more hurt than the mother. So you go and heal back more of the father, and you would be 10 feet away from them for the next action.
All right, perfect. Do you need me to do a roll or something?
No, I'll just take it in consideration with what's happening.
Okay, cool.
We'll now go with Timber. But you'd still need to spend a spell slot, though.
So, they were 6 total. Now it's...
They were 6. They're now...
5.
Down to 5 and 4 when Dermot squashed. There's one at the other beginning that is still healthy, and 3 that are frozen in ice. one that is not frozen in ice, and two that are frozen in ice.
Hey, I'll cast old person at fourth level on all of them.
Okay.
You said you ain't moving.
You bitch is not moving. Okay. So no give joke, me that spell. Please.
There.
Okay.
As wisdom.
They're not, it's not their forte.
That's good.
So I guess if you advance to reach out for the one at the other end?
Yeah, the range on this is pretty short, though.
It's 60 feet. It's 60 feet.
Okay.
So the one that is actually at the other end beating up the parents succeeds.
Of course, it's that person.
Yes, it's that person.
I'll get my spirit next to me and
east.
Concentration and hope you guys can benefit from some auto crits. My turn.
All right. You see that they were beating up the guy and bricks. Back to you.
Nearest target, Eldritch Blast.
Which one are you targeting? The one that are stuck in ice and old? Or you want the one that is not at the other end beating up the parents?
Oh, the other end then. Let's lob some things here.
You're like... you're... Eldritch Blast.
I mean, I have 240 feet of range. Oh, yeah. Lob some shots at those guys. Especially with the beating up parents. First throw.
That's and pretty good. You have advantage because he's recklessly attacking them.
His second roll is better. It's not, so either way... Damage. That's pretty good damage.
That is indeed pretty good damage. So 12 in. So second beam.
All right, now I'll do the advantage properly.
23. With
damage.
For against, we
that's
damage.
That's also good damage.
So 22 total. Good. Anything else during your turn?
Nope. That's it.
All right. And while they're beating up, no, nothing will stop me from saving this world of this rudest born. And he's beating up the parents pretty hard. But now it is Andy's turn. Andy was close, and he will go. He will close up with the guy that would be still attacking them. So Molly, it will hit. Oh my god, even me rolled bad damage.
It's just like the Ahri curse. Rolling low with all of her characters.
29 there. And he would probably bump 5 feet so he would not hit the parents again. He will close up, then mull again. For now, sweet damage of 15. 30. 40, 4. Alright. So, that was Andy's turn. We're now going to them. Andy's going to be attacked. Oh, it hits this one. So, Andy's getting hurt by a 10 point. And then one on Squish. Nope. Oof. Luckily, nope.
Nope.
And
I have shield.
The others closing up with Mother Bowen.
They're paralyzed, the others.
The two others, yes. Yeah, I have to do a strength check, right?
Wisdom. So there's 3 out of 4 that needs to save at the end of their turn. So they lose their turn.
Okay, so they lose their turn here. Normal. They don't save.
Still paralyzed. Save. No, 16.
Doesn't save, so they're holding into place. Still then. And now we're going back to Squish.
There's 3, no? Last one?
I messed up one of the attack earlier, so I just skip it up. Because I made him attack Mother Bowen.
But there's 3 paralyzed, so there's 3 saving throws, no?
Yes, but I made him attack, and I failed, but so I'll just consider that he failed his saving throw.
Okay.
I it was my mistake. So we're going with Squish.
I'm going to. Let me see. I'm going to spend 2 sorcery points to make my Scorching Ray a bonus action.
Okay.
I'm going to cast it at 5th level.
Oh, shit.
So that is... that 5 ray? Wait.
It's 3 ray basically at the number 2. So 5th would be 3 additional rays, so it's 6 rays.
6 rays, okay. Do any look close to dead?
Three of them seems to be badly injured, and okay. One of them is untouched, but paralyzed.
I'm going to do 2 rays at each
okay.
one that's damaged. Ray.
And do 2 last?
Okay. The one that's beside me, I have advantage on.
Yes.
And the one that's beside Andy, is there one of the damaged one beside Andy?
Yes.
So I ask. Okay, so I guess I have advantage on all of them. Because pack tactics.
Yes.
Yeah? Cool.
And there, 3 of them are auto crits because of
melee, melee only.
Oh, melee only. Okay.
Yeah. But so, you have advantage as well for that reason.
Yeah. It's 20. Do we want to count 24 for all of them?
Let's go for it. Let's go for it because since the system is buggy a bit. So 7.
14 on all of them.
All right.
Because it's. Was 2 on each.
Well, actually, I'm wrong. Paralyze says any attack that hits a creature as long as you're within 5 feet.
So the one next to him, next to Squish, would be actually a crit.
An auto crit, so that's an extra 12 on top of that, on that one.
Yep. So the 3 of Squish, them are dead. The only one...
has a moment of looking at them and just starts like cackling as he opens his mouth, and as he laughs, a ray comes out each time of like a little mini fireball. Explodes on them. Yeah. Smoke left kind of. Yeah.
And the only one left is the one
that worked.
Attacking at the end. Well, he's now bunked by Andy.
Bonus action.
He's damaged.
I don't have any bonus actions. So that's my turn.
All right. We're going with Dermot. Dermot is going to run towards Andy and arrive next to him, but he will do a Searing Wrath on his way there. With advantage. Let me check. I will take the 21 radiant damage. All right, and you will make a Rudium Warhammer attack with advantage. So 12 plus. Okay, well, with all the deflagration and everything that happens, the 6 bandits, well, farmers, like, ugh! Curse the newborn child. And you see the parents just survived the situation. Let me just switch the music.
Which one of us is Rudy unborn?
It's not us. It's about Alexion.
Right.
Oh, which one of us is Alexion then?
None of us.
What do you mean, which one of us?
Well, The mom told one of us to go back. Inside.
I mean, what'd she ask? You talking to us?
Swish. With that, is just like panic, gonna start looking around to see if there is a small child somewhere.
But right now, the parents are not taking you in consideration. Like, they're not taking you as you would be. Well, actually, they look at you and they're like, it's okay, Alex. We knew. And you are a gem to us. Don't let them think that because you were born under the red moon, you're cursed to live a life of bad things. Anybody says something?
Are you looking specifically at Squish or the
group? At everybody.
Okay.
Thanks? Rick says awkwardly.
Oh, poor guy.
Anyone's interacting with the parents?
I'll go and hug them.
No problem, Mom and Dad. Finger guns. There I am.
Timber?
Yes.
When you hug them, you feel a bit of warmth and comfort. And you hear what I understood from a young age is this. Because of me, they would always suffer. When you'll be leaving here, you will not be able to come back. Thanks. Make me see something I cannot do. Could not do back then.
When Timber disengages, he has wet eyes a little bit.
Who hurt Alexion? Was meant for Timber? Or all of us?
Only Timber hurt it.
Yeah.
And when you disengage from the parents, they're fading out as memories.
It's so sad. I heard Alexion speak to me.
Oh. What did it told you?
It said its parent suffered because of him a lot. But there was a warning. It says when we'll be leaving this place, we won't be able to come back. And he's also thanking us from doing what he couldn't do. But I don't know if it's this memory or the nether deep that we are in. I hope we're not trapped here.
Oh, poor Alexion. Well, there's one thing that it should know when someone is loves like a parent is when you have a child or accept to be in charge of someone, you're ready to give pretty much everything, protect them. And I know it costs them a lot, but I'm pretty sure they were pretty, well, from what I heard, they were pretty aware and consent to do this sacrifice. And they were still happy to be its parent, no matter what.
I hope so. So, how do we get out of here?
In the farther distance, you see that the world that surrounds you is slowly evaporating. And you see in the far distance, like, the same walls with rhodium laced place, but you are still into the home of Elixion. And everybody hears. Thank you, Mother Bowen, for these kind words.
Hi, Papa. What? Oh, this is confusing.
Everything of my past memory seems to be a burden. Even these toys. Like I said earlier, when Squishquash entered, they no longer hold a special place in my heart. But they might be worth something to you.
Would you like us to give meaning to them?
There's no answers.
I'll take the nearest toy and pocket it.
The teddy bear?
Sure.
Do you take care of doing it with your bare hands, or you're taking care of the rhodium on it?
Oh, they're I forgot they're tainted for rhodium.
I totally forgot. I think there's a heart piece for this one. I fucked up.
Oh, nice. I fucked up.
I'll gently touch it first, then, if it seems.
Yes, this.
Okay. That's nasty. Yeah. Okay, so.
Yeah, I'll gently poke the corruption part and see what happens to me and how it reacts. I'm happy to be the guinea pig, guys.
I mean, if it wasn't going to be you, it would have been me.
I'm ready, guys. I'm ready.
I was going to pull out a blanket.
So no problem.
I got your attention. I got grabby hands. Everything goes in the bag.
Yeah, I mean, that's just a fact.
I just noticed the photo.
Yeah.
Jesus.
That's why the blanket to grab the bear and put it in a bag.
Nope. Grabby hands. Let's go.
God damn it.
You have to give it meaning. It's not just a thing. It's like, when you were a child, what would you do with your favorite toys?
I was supposed to have a favorite toy?
Or your toys in general.
I do plan to cherish this little bear.
Are you giving it a name?
Well, I might if it doesn't hurt me.
That's fair.
So as the room fickles out, you are inside a small room when you are right above. Let me just drag all the characters. That was weird. But, maybe Io and the others found stuff, too. It's the only place to go through.
I'm just... How did they not do the... there? Or did they not see the parents? Or did they let the parents die without knowing? It was hard to see out that window.
I had to move something. The memory repeats itself.
That's a good output, Timber.
And did the toys vanish to...
Nope, around? The toys are still in your stuff.
I see there's a mobile above the crib.
Yes.
If I gently spin it, does it make any music or...
No, it was just a spinning one. So if you it just moved.
Well, Motherborn's gonna sing lullabies then while spinning it gently.
And you're back in the room and nothing more of the memories is still in there. Only Rudim, rock, water. You're back to swimming.
Well, that was freaky.
And I guess that the rest of this place will probably be the same thing.
Oh God, you're right.
I hope there's some pleasant memories too. Probably not.
I expect a lot more pain and suffering, to be quite honest. This is not going to be nice.
So we better bottle up with everything that's happening, huh? Oh gosh, I hope the other four are okay.
I'm sure they are. They gotta be.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're like heroes or some shit.
Heroes pretty much are like always you guys.
Okay. Oh, I am great, aren't I?
You are all, yes. Nobody would go this deep into this whole mess to save someone you've seen in a vision. Well,
yeah.
I guess we have to go to the next memories from here. Left or right?
I mean, right. That's my vote.
So as you're moving, sure. As you're moving right, we'll end tonight's episode to have a fully Harry, and I think actually she's traveling in the next game, like in LA, she's going or something like that.
Is it next? Is it in 2 weeks? What I think it is in 2 weeks.
I think you might be right.
So we might not have Harry, but with all this campaign going on, we will need. Well, not everybody on board, so we'll go with you four in 2 weeks. And let's go through a little roundtable quickly. So, Timber, how did you find your game?
Pretty cool. Can't wait to go down memory lane. I mean, it's only going to get worse.
You're right.
But it's interesting. I love the idea. Enjoyed the game. Can't wait for next one.
Mother Bowen, I know you're taking care of the dogs.
Yes, I'm not wrestling with baby. Not at all.
So, it was a pretty nice game. A little encounter, a lot of emotional role-playing, puzzling things, always my cup of tea. And I would like to thank everybody for those small moments that you allowed me in the first part of the game. It was very pleasant.
The mother Bowen therapist and cleric.
I'm expecting a pill.
Ready for the day.
And let's fill it up with a squish squash.
This is kind of cool. This is like a neat twist I was not expecting. So I'm excited to see how this goes. It's really cool.
Yeah, I can't wait for the rest of the whole thing. I read this thing twice a week to be sure to narrate pretty everything quickly. Because these memories are so freaking nice, but also, well, a lot of stuff that you can use. And Brix, how did you find your game?
I had to go to therapy. I don't like therapy. But it was a good overall game. Some good combat. I still haven't done the thing I told myself to do, so I'm going to have to transcribe my note from last game to this game. Ooh. And try to remember to do it this time.
Okay, we see. So, with all that... Well, with my tonight, like I said a bit earlier, I really liked to share the story of Elixion is coming up and to see different ways and why you've explored the Apothian story since the very beginning of all that into the Sanine's Grotto, where you've been fighting this silver shimmering shark. And one note that you all, mostly Timber, doing things in divisions that seems to be adding a little more. Like Timber, comforting the parents with a hug, did emotional healing to the situation. And it will work in the end game.
Well, guys, I am going to be useless because this sounds like some being good thing.
There's not only being good, but that stuff that might happen. There's a deeper meaning to those visions, and it works with the final battle that you will have to do.
Duly noted.
You know, I just want to say I'm pretty sure my finger guns actually were what did it, and Timber just happened to be the closest one. Gotta hit him with the riz.
Bzz, 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 bzz. So it is Quinscape. So I see that there's people playing Pathfinder. Questcape, one of the TikToker that I really like, it's Tank, the Viking dude that is working out and like doing wholesome shit. So he's one of the player. So let's go up there and thank you. So next week, be sure to tune in for the Star Wars French campaign that I am running with the Fate Core system. That is a system that I'm loving more and more that the game is going through. And after two game of combat. But it doesn't feel like a combat with Fate, so it looks more cinematic with everything that is going on. But the already two hands has been cut off into the first two episodes.
Wow!
Maybe one coming.
Maybe one more coming.
Jeez!
It's Star Wars. Always a hands cut off.
Like, I know everyone wants to be Luke Skywalker, but this is ridiculous.
They are the one that cut them.
That just makes it worse.
They're making Luke Skywalkers everywhere.
Please but don't.
It's this Thursday. Not this Thursday. Thursday next week. And we will be coming back right up with Call of the Netherdeep in 2 weeks. Stay tuned. And we have a start date for Exandria campaign.
Ooh.
Let me just check it up. It's at the end of the month. And Ari... if she have a better internet, we'll be able to be with us.
Yes.
Woo.
Whoa, not sharing all my info on the stream.
Jeez. Do not dox yourself.
Gosh.
Do not dox yourself.
Man, unless you Ooh, really God. Want to, but...
No, we do not dox ourselves. A lot of content creators have been swatted in the last week. Let's not. Good job, Mary.
All right. Come on. Well... Let me check it out over here. Why are you not working? Give me the... Okay. So, calendar. It's the first game that will be split in two. So it's a game 1 and 1.5 because the party will be split at the very beginning like I did with the Mavericks back then. It will be the first game on the 28th of September and the other game after the 12th. October of her Exandria campaign. And one thing that I can say right now, they chose the faction that it will be playing in, and it's going to be the Cerberus Assembly.
That might be the sure villain. Sounds of the story. Like a faction.
Nice. I'll have to check that up.
It's a magocracy where it's leaded by the strongest wizards and arcane users, mostly. Into the wild.
That sure
country.
Sounds like something evil.
Not evil, runs the country. Just mostly.
Just I'm very expecting magic. Authoritarianism.
The powerful.
Well, it'll be a great time.
Yes, it will be. It will be, and the whole Not crew will be working for them, either as direct members or subcontractors. So it's going to be fun. So let's launch the raid to Quest Keep. And they're all dressed up also. So thank you.
Ooh.
See you next, not this Thursday, but the Thursday next week.
2 weeks.
See you, peeps. And as we always say, may your fumbles become epic stories. And as the oddities that you can see every Sunday is at 7 says...
Eat your condoms.
Eat your condoms.
Yeah. All right, bye-bye.
Bye. Oh, my God. It was one of my openers or one of my, like, intros. I was like, I'm you under your bed time. Eating your condoms.
Yes, no, I have my
point. And everyone was like, what the fuck? So it's just, like, a thing that I say.